CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So friends, let's join in Dhwani Shala class 5.
Hello children, I hope all of you are having good time at home. I am Gitanjali from GSKV number 1, Model Town 3rd, Delhi, and today I am your partner. And I would like to take you to the life of fishermen and sea. But how? We are going to take chapter 1 of class 5, The Fish Tale. This is episode 2 of the same chapter. Before I start, I want to tell you about my personal experience of my visit to Andaman and Nicobar Island. Last December, I went to Andaman and Nicobar Island. I have never seen the sea till then. The first time I saw the sea, I was surprised to see such a huge amount of water. It was all blue and green. I enjoyed playing in water and walking on the seashore. Walking on the sand and collecting seashells was the most interesting thing. You know what? The sea waves were so high that sometimes I got scared of the same when it came near me. I have seen various types of boats and fishermen with them. Life of fishermen is not so easy. They have to face huge hurdles to earn their food or their livelihood. Today, I would like to talk about some of the fishermen and their boats. One of them is Nasir. Nasir is a poor fisherman. Nasir has a simple boat. His boat is made up of wood tied together with the help of rope. That is why it is called a log boat. This boat cannot go so far. In case of high tides and strong winds, these boats are not safe at all. Fishermen has to face lots of difficulties. They have to risk their life to earn their living. Nasir, using a log boat, can go up to 4 kilometers in 1 hour only if the wind is in his support. So, the speed of the log boat is only 4 km per hour. So, children, can you tell the distance covered by Nasir in 3 km? I guess this is easy for you. As you know, in 1 hour, Nasir log boat can travel up to 4 km. So, in 2nd hour, he can travel 4 plus 4, that is 8 kilometers. And in 3rd hour, he can travel 4 plus 4 plus 4, that is 12 kilometers. Or you can say 3 times 4, which is 3 multiplied by 4, that is 12 kilometers. So finally, we can say that Nasir's log boat can travel up to 12 kilometers in 3 hours. Now, if Nasir has to travel 3.5 hours, then calculate the distance traveled. If you remember, in our last question, we have calculated the distance traveled in 3 hours. And now, we need to calculate the distance for 1/2 hour. So, what is the easiest way to calculate that distance? 1 hour travel is equal to 4 kilometers. 1/2 hour? Yes, half of the 1 hour is 30 minutes. And it will be equal to 1/2 of 4 kilometers, which is 2 kilometers. So, can you now join our times and kilometers? You have already calculated the distance traveled in 3 hours in your previous question. It was 12 kilometers. Now, we have calculated the distance traveled in 30 minutes, that is half hour, and the distance is 2 kilometers. Now, we need to just add both the distance to get the distance traveled in 3 and half hour, that is 12 kilometers plus 2 kilometers, that will make 14 kilometers. So finally, we can say that the boat Nasir has can travel in 3 and a half hour up to the distance of 14 kilometers. Now let's change the situation. We have talked about a lot to calculate the distance. Now, if Nasir has to go to 10 kilometers, can you tell me how much time will it take? Think and try. As you know, that log boat of Nasir can go up to 4 kilometers in 1 hour. Out of 10, 6 kilometers are left now. As we can subtract 4 kilometers from 10 kilometers, we will have only 6 kilometers left. Now, he need 1 more hour to go 4 more kilometers. Again, it is 4 plus 4, that is 8 kilometers in 2 hours. So, how much distance is left? Now, he is left with 10 minus 8, that is 2 kilometers. And we have discussed earlier that for 2 kilometers, log boat will take 30 minutes. If you remember the previous question. Yes. So, total time taken by Nasir to travel 10 kilometers will be 1 plus 1 plus half hour. That will be 2 and a half hour. So, we can say that to travel up to 10 kilometers, Nasir need 2 hours and 30 minutes. Now, if you walk, estimate the distance traveled in 1 hour. I am giving you 2 situations. When you walk in normal speed, calculate the distance traveled in 1 hour. And then again, when you walk fast, calculate the distance traveled in 1 hour and see the difference between your speed when you walk fast and your speed when you walk normal, right? So, moving further, I would like to tell you the special technique fishermen use while going for fishing. Nasir and the other fishermen can sense the wind. They can find their way of going ahead by looking at the sun. But the common people like you, me, might forget our way as there is only water all around. We cannot easily find out where to go if we lost in the sea. But Nasir and the fishermen can find out their way in the sea by looking at the sun only. I hope you guys know the direction from where the sun rises. The sun rises from east and sets in west. As I said, Nasir has a small log boat which cannot go far in the sea. To increase his earning, he needs to think better. He needs to have more fishes. And for that, he has to plan something new. In sea, fishermen search for the places where they can find a huge amount of fishes. They have to go far into the sea to locate such places. But with a log boat, Nasir can't go more than 4 or 5 kilometers. So finally, he decided to buy another boat that can help him to buy to get more fishes. He went to see some of the boats. He has seen the long tail boat and the motor boat. He went to see some of the motor boats of his friends so that he can plan to buy a new boat according to his budget. Do you know what is a motor boat? I'll tell you about the motor boat. A boat having motor inside can go farther into the sea. Just like a motorcycle can run faster on road, can cover more distance as compared to the normal bicycle. The motor boats are like that. They can cover more distance as compared to the log boat in same time. So, Nasir has planned to buy a motor boat to get more fishes. He said that a motor boat can travel 20 kilometers in 1 hour. So, what is the speed of the motor boat? The speed of the motor boat is 20 kilometers per hour, which means in 1 hour, motor boat can go up to 20 kilometers. Can you tell me how much faster is motor boat from the log boat of Nasir? Think. Nasir's log boat can travel 4 kilometers in 1 hour, while the motor boat can travel 20 kilometers in 1 hour. So 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4. That means 4 adding 5 times will make 20. Or you can say 5 times 4, which is 20. It means motorboat is 5 times faster than Nasir's logboat. So, will it be good for Nasir or not? Yes, it will surely save his time and efforts, and he will earn more because now he can earn approximately 5 times more than the previous earnings. Okay, let me ask you a question. As you know, the speed of the motor boat is 20 kilometers per hour. How much distance it will cover in 3.5 hours? Can you find out? Let's find out together. In 1 hour, motorboat covers 20 kilometers. In 2 hours, it will cover 2 times 20 or 20 plus 20, that is 40 kilometers. In 3 hours, it will cover 3 times 20, that means 20 plus 20 plus 20, that is 60 kilometers. So now, in half hour, how much it will cover? In half hour, the boat will cover half of 20 kilometers, which is 10 kilometers. So, in 3.5 hour, the motor boat will cover 20 plus 20 plus 20 plus 10, that is 70 kilometers. Am I right? You can check this with your answers too. Now, we can say that the motorboat of Nasir can go up to 70 kilometers in 3.5 hours. Now let us have another question. Let's say you have this motorboat and you want to go to 85 kilometers far into the sea. Now tell me how much time it will take. Think twice. Okay, first of all, what is the speed of your motorboat? It is already mentioned 20 kilometers per hour, as we have taken already. Now think about the distance you want to go. It is 85 kilometers. So, can we take out 20 kilometers out of 85 kilometers to decide how much time it will take? Yes. So, let's do it. 85 minus 20. When the boat will go in first hour, it will take 20 kilometers. So, we will subtract 20 from 85. Now we have 65 kilometers left. Then again, one more hour travel. So, we can subtract 20 one more time. 65 minus 20 is equal to 45 kilometers. Now, again, we can subtract 20 kilometers from 45. We have 25 kilometers left. And in the last, 25 minus 20, that is 5 kilometers. So, how many times we could take out 20 from 85? Can we count? Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4. It is 4 times, means 4 hours. Now, what about the last 5 kilometers? So, if motorboat can go 20 kilometers in 1 hour, which is 60 minutes. The 1 hour, you know, is of 60 minutes. Now, 5 kilometer is 1/4 part of 20. If we divide it equally, like 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 makes 20. So, 5 is 1/4 of 20. Now, 60 minutes will be divided in 4 equal parts, which is 15 and 15 and 15 and 15. That will make 60 minutes. Ultimately, 15 minutes is for 5 kilometers. Now, we can say, for the distance of 85 kilometers, we have broken into 20 plus 20 plus 20 plus 20 plus 5, the motorboat will take 1 hour plus 1 hour plus 1 hour plus 1 hour plus 15 minutes. So, it is 4.5 hours. Finally, Nasir can think to buy the motorboat because he can see that he will have many benefits of buying a motorboat in terms of getting more fish and getting more money. You can also calculate the distance traveled by your bicycle that you ride and the distance traveled by the motorbike or the scooter your father ride. So, to find out the difference between logboat and motorboat, I would suggest you to calculate the difference between the speed of your bicycle and the speed of your father's motorbike. You can easily see that how fast is the motorbike runs than to your bicycle. So today we have discussed about sea, its beauty, life of the fisherman and the challenges he faced to earn his livelihood. Fisherman has to think for other alternatives to get more fishes. The other example we have is a long tail boat, which is almost different from the log boat. And at the end, we have a motorboat that has motor fitted inside the boat. And benefits of motorboat is that it can go farther into the sea due to its speed. It can go 5 times more faster than any of the log boat the fisherman has. So now you can compare the speed of both types of boats according to your own calculation. As I told you about Nasir and his log boat, and further he bought a new boat, that is a motor boat. I have seen another boat with his friend. He has a friend named Sunil. Sunil has a long tail boat, and Nasir and Sunil were comparing both of the boats so that they can decide whose boat is better and who can earn more money in same time. So now we have some more question based on the boats and their comparison. Nasir and his friend Sunil are discussing their boats. Nasir, as you know, has a motor boat, while Sunil has a long tail boat. The speed of long tail boat is 12 kilometers in 1 hour. That means the boat can travel up to 12 kilometers in 1 hour, while the motor boat Nasir has can go 20 kilometers in 1 hour, as we have already discussed this. Now, the speed of long tail boat is 12 kilometers per hour. If we compare the speed of the boat, you can easily see which boat is faster. Obviously, it is the motor boat having speed of 20 kilometers per hour. Now, let us have some questions. Let us compare both the boats. If both the boats start from the same time, how much distance they can travel in 4 hours. So, in first situation, we have the long tail boat of Sunil. What is the speed of the boat? It is 12 kilometers per hour. Now, find out how much distance it can travel in 4 hours. So, in first hour, the distance traveled by the long tail boat is 12 kilometers. In second hour, distance traveled by the long tail boat will be 2 times. That means 12 plus 12. That will make 24 kilometers. Now, we have to go up to 4 kilometers. So, the distance traveled in third hour will be 12 plus 12 plus 12. That will be 36 kilometers. Yes. Now, in fourth hour, the distance traveled by the long tail boat will be 12 plus 12 plus 12 plus 12. That will be 4 times 12. And it will make 48 kilometers. So, in 4 hours, the boat of Sunil can go up to 48 kilometers. Now, let us go for the another boat that Nasir has. Nasir's motor boat. The speed of Nasir's motor boat is 20 kilometers, as you know. So, in first hour, it will go up to 20 kilometers. In second hour, it will go up to 20 plus 20. That is 2 times 20, which is 40 kilometers. And in third hour, it will go up to 20 plus 20 plus 20. That is 3 times 20. And it will be 60 kilometers. And in 4th hour, boat of Nasir will go up to 4 times 20. That will be 80 kilometers. So, you can see that the Nasir's boat, the motor boat, can go up to 80 kilometers in 4 hours. While the long tail boat of Sunil can go up to 48 kilometers in 4 hours. So, which of the boat is getting more distance in 4 hours? It is the Nasir's motor boat. Now, Nasir is happy because he has invested his money in the right boat so that he can earn better. In the end, I would like to summarize what we have learnt today. We have discussed about the sea, its beauty, life of the fishermen and their struggles for their earning. They have to face huge challenges to live with the sea. Further, we have discussed about the types of boats. The very first one was the logboat, which is made up of wood and tied up with the help of rope. Since it is less in speed as compared to the other boats and it cannot go farther, the fisherman has to take some new boats. One of the boat is the long tail boat, which can go much farther into the sea. And the last we have learned about the motor boat that has motor inside, and because of that motor it can go faster as compared to the other boats of the fishermen. Further, we will discuss more about the boats, the fish market and the competition in the market. Till then, you can find more about the sea, the fishermen and the sea animals. Thank you.
Friends, you are just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistant Kusum Lata. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and Mayank Kumar. Produced by Vimlesh Chaudhary. And this program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.